I'm leading at EMPA the Environmental Risk Assessment and Management Group. Since 2008, the group was involved in 18 EU projects. The support by the EU is the most important source of research funding for the group. Within these EU projects, 5 PhD theses were completed and 6 postdocs and 4 scientific collaborators worked on the projects. All projects were devoted to the assessment and control of the risks and chances of nanomaterials and nanotechnology. The continuous funding by the EU allowed us to gain worldwide a leading position in the research area on the environmental aspects of nanomaterials. Whereas one of the basic outcomes of EU projects are project reports, we always strive to write scientific publications that then form the basis for the reports. Many of the publications that originated from the EU projects are highly cited by other scientists and form a basis for the scientific success of the group.
Hello, I'm Natasha Stinman, and I started working as a scientific assistant at EMPA about a year ago. I work on a European project called GreenSense, which aims to develop nanocellulose-based printed electronics in the form of a biosensor. EMPA is in charge of the sustainability assessment of the overall product and materials, so my work involves performing an environmental risk assessment of nanocellulose and using life cycle analysis to help identify where impacts could be reduced during the product development. I'm new to working within EU projects, but so far it seems to be a very positive space for collaboration. There are 13 partners in our project based throughout Europe who range from research institutes to industry, as well as companies interested in the final product being developed. So being able to interact with such a wide range of people and organizations as a young scientist is very interesting and enriching. We'll be relying on data from our partners, so it is also nice to see that they are interested in the sustainability aspect of the project and in finding out how they might be able to improve their product. So for me, the short time I have been within an EU project has overall been a positive experience thanks to the diversity of the consortium.
I work as a PhD student in the BioRima project. The BioRima project evaluates the risks of nanobiomaterials, and the goal of my thesis is the modeling of these nanomaterials in the body, but most notably in the environment. More than 30 partners are working in the BioRima project, each with different specializations, backgrounds and expertise. This way I get to see different aspects and viewpoints on topics and problems. Besides, it's always interesting to see what other partners are doing and what they're working with and developing. Additionally, it is obviously a great way to network and meet other partners with similar interests. Especially for me, with little experience in the field, this is a great opportunity.
I am involved in the NanoPhase European project, which aims at assessing the amounts and the forms of nanomaterials that reach the environment. NanoPhase is a big project involving 35 partners from all over Europe. So we meet every 6 months, and I travel often and to nice places like Barcelona, Amsterdam, or Athens. Partners involved are both from academia and industry. Researchers are chemists, hydrologists, biologists, modelers, or experimentalists. And I like this diversity of fields. It gives me the opportunity to learn a lot on the different aspects of the behavior and toxicity of nanomaterials. Within this project, I work closely with Spanish, Dutch, and French partners. We are writing a paper together, which is very good both to develop group work skills and for my CV, since this will show that I'm able to work with people outside my institution, that I have some independence. Most of the time, I am the only representative of EMPA at these meetings, which helped me gaining self-confidence and recognition. Big projects such as NanoPhase are very helpful to young researchers because you can talk both to other young researchers and to other people more advanced in their careers and sometimes very well recognized in the field. So it's great to build your network. A few of us actually created a group for young scientists working on nanotechnologies. The purpose of this group is to know better and to support each other. It started small within the project partners and is now expanding through Europe and the US. So all in all, the main reasons why I'm very happy to be part of this project are the increase of my independence and the development of my network.